a couple of things for you, featuring the guitar. I don't want to block anyone.
Just
watch out for bees.
Yeah, we were going to try and do a Breton dance whilst playing the guitar, but we gave up on that after the idea was thwarted. Anyway, we're going to play you one tune here, and it's I haven't got a title for it. I think it's probably Scottish. It's a sort of dainty little real march thing. Here we are. I spent most of the week trying to get my Bluetooth speaker to work without success, so that's why we haven't really got very much to play on the parade. So if you go, here's two bits of music that we've put together. First is a dreamy, slightly Breton sounding tune by Niall Valerie. Cambridge, and they've got room for a slightly smelly guitar player with a small suitcase. That'd be great. Not many offers there. Huh?
Jump
on the bike and play.
Oh,
fantastic! Thank you. Great. Well, see you all next year. Great. So yeah, we have the balls track, and then we're going to go into a slip jig called Bob's Hole in One. Now I got this from the inimitable Mr. Kevin Crawford, and Kev nearly got into trouble with this tune because he initially wrote it for someone else and called it One in a Million, and then he decided that his other friend, who he owed a tune to, probably deserved it more, so he changed the name to fit in with this friend, and this friend of his was called Bob, oddly enough, and he was a very keen golfer, and one day got what every golfer wants to do, I believe, I wouldn't know, but a hole in one. So rather imaginatively, Kevin decided to call his tune Bob's Hole in One. It takes great delight in telling people that it often gets abridged to just simply Bob's Hole. So I'd like to thank these very fine people for sitting in a darkened room with me for several hours a day. I don't know how they do it.
Wait, you locked the door.
So, just give us 10 minutes, right? I'm just going to talk to you.
So, the first tune three times.